अस्सलाम वालेकुम बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास, ऑनलाइन क्लास अरेंज बाय द सीएसएस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द यस्टरडेज लेसन। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द आइडेंटिटीज व्हिच वी डिस्कस्ड यस्टरडे। यू आर ऑलरेडी फेमिलियर विद Yesterday we discussed about the reciprocal trigonometric ratios, and those are it is cosecant theta is equal to 1 over sine theta, secant theta is reciprocal of cos, and cotangent theta is reciprocal of tangent theta. So it is cosecant, secant and cotangent. You can read it as cosec, sec and cot, otherwise it is the proper word is cosecant, secant and cotangent. So these are the identities which we discussed yesterday. Today we are going to sketch the graphs of secant, cosecant and cotangent, and as they are the reciprocal functions of sine, cos and tan, so to understand how to sketch their graph, first we have to see to draw to sketch the graph of cosecant, we will draw first sketch the graph of sign. Now this dotted sketch represents the sketch of sine theta. So it is sketch of sine theta. To sketch the graph of cosecant, what I am going to do is in this graph, where there is the value on the curve is zero, I am going to change it into infinity. And where it is infinity, I'm going to change into zero. One will remain one and minus one will remain minus one. On the sine curve, it starts from zero value. At this stage, its value is 1. Here again is 0. Here it is 0. Here it is minus 1. So remember what we have to do. Zero is going to be changed into infinity. This zero is going to be changed into infinity. 1 will remain 1. So we will sketch it in this manner. Along y-axis, it becomes an asymptote. It becomes almost parallel to y-axis, doesn't touches the y-axis. So one on the sine curve remains one. Zero becomes undefined. Zero becomes undefined, which is represented by a vertical and asymptote. And we know that sine is positive in first two quadrants, 0 to 90 and 90 to 180. These are the first two quadrants. So sine is positive in first two quadrants. That's why this curve is in the positive section as well. 180 to 270 and 270 to 360, second quadrant and third quadrant. Second and third quadrant, we know sine is negative. That's why this curve minus 1 remains minus 1. This 0 becomes infinity. 0 becomes infinity. So it will be sketched in this manner. So it is the sketch of cosecant theta. So the curve upward and downward, these two parts are representing the sketch of cosecant theta. So you people are well prepared, or well known curve for you is the sine curve. So just have to follow the sine curve and just change values accordingly. So zero changed into infinity, zero to infinity. And keep in mind one thing, which quadrant it is lying. If it is first and second quadrant, sine is positive, so cosecant is also positive. In third and fourth quadrant, sine is negative, so cosecant is also negative. So it is a sketch of cosecant theta. Similarly, if I want to draw the sketch of secant theta, first I should draw the sketch for cos. It is a sketch of cos theta. Again, you have to follow the same procedure. The dotted curve is representing cos theta. Again, you have to follow the same procedure that zero is converted into infinity, infinity into 0, 1 remains 1, minus 1 remains minus 1. On this curve, this 1 value remains 1, 0 becomes undefined. So for that purpose, I'm just drawing a dotted vertical line to show how the graph behaves. So Z1 remains 1, this 0 has been changed into infinity. And I know in first quadrant, 0 to 90 degree, cos is positive. So that's why it is a positive curve. From 90 to 270, second and third quadrant, cos is negative. So that's why the curve will be below x-axis, or below, say, so minus 1 remains 1, this 0 becomes undefined. Again, it will behave like that. This is a sketch for, and then the fourth quadrant cos is again positive, so the positive curve will get. For secant theta, the curve is drawn in this manner. So what I have done, first I sketched the graph for cos theta, and then I have changed the shape according to this rule that 1 is changed into infinity, infinity into 0, 1 into 1, minus 1 into, minus 1 remains minus 1. So 1 remained 1, this 0 has been changed into infinity, and infinity we show as a asymptote parallel to y-axis. The curve becomes parallel to y-axis. And it was first quadrant, that's why it is lying in the positive section. In second and third quadrant, 90 to 180, 180 to 270 is second and third quadrant. That's why curve is in the negative section. It is below x-axis, and minus 1 remains minus 1 for both curve of cos or cosecant, but zeros changed into infinity. Fourth quadrant, 270 to 360. Cos is positive, that's why the curve is in a positive section. This zero value has been changed into infinity. Our third sketch is for cotangent. For that purpose, I have to draw the sketch of tan. Zero, 90 degree, 180, 270, 360. Value of tan at 0 is 0, at 90, tan is undefined. So its curve behaves something like that. From 90 to 180, again, at 90 it is undefined, at 180 it is 0. But it's the second quadrant, in second quadrant, tan is negative. So the curve will behave in this manner. In second quadrant, it is in a negative section. In third quadrant, tan is positive. Therefore, it is in positive section. In fourth quadrant, again, tan is negative. At 270, it is undefined because it is negative 90 degree. And at 360, it is 0. So it will be like that. So this dotted curves represents the sketch for the tan theta. Cot theta. Again, I'm going to follow the same technique. The zero is changed into infinity, and infinity is changed into zero. So this graph behave like that. So this curve, this complete curve is for cot theta. In second quadrant, because tan is negative, cot will be also negative. Infinity becomes zero, and this zero becomes infinity. So it will be behaving like that. Third quadrant, tan is positive, so sketch of cot will also be positive. Zero becomes undefined and infinity becomes zero. So it will be like that. Fourth quadrant, again, tan is negative. This infinity becomes zero and zero becomes infinity. So it goes so it is sketch. The first one was for tan theta, and the second one is for cot theta. The dotted is for tan theta, and the complete curves was for the cot theta. So this is how we have to sketch, and you need a lot of practice for that. You must practice at home, otherwise you cannot draw this sketch just by seeing on the board. So one thing you have to keep in mind that while sketching, 0 becomes infinity, infinity becomes 0, 1 remains 1, minus 1 remains minus 1. Now I am going to solve some questions from the exercise and I will send you the snaps of this exercise. You can try at home. Find exact value of cosecant 135 degree. Before that, I'm going to write the formulas. Sine 180 minus theta is sine theta. Cos 180 minus theta is minus cos theta. Tan 180 minus theta is equal to minus tan theta. Sine 90 minus theta is cos theta. Cos 90 minus theta is sine, and tan 90 minus theta is cot theta. And remember why it is so. Sine 180 minus theta, if theta is acute angle, if theta is acute angle, then 180 minus theta lies in second quadrant, and in second quadrant sine is positive. That's why we are taking positive sine theta. 180 minus theta, again it is in second quadrant, and second quadrant cos is positive, cos is negative, that's why taking negative cos theta. Tan is also negative in second quadrant. Similarly, sine 90 minus theta lies in first quadrant, but it just changes from sine to cos. Cos changes into sine, and tan changes into cot or 1 over tan. So we need these formulas. That's why I have just mentioned them. I can write it as 1 over cosecant. I know it is equal to 1 over sine theta. I need to change it into acute angle. For that purpose, instead of writing 135, I have written 180 minus 45. 180 minus 45 will be 35. Using this formula, I can write it as 1 over sine 45. And the value of sine 45 is known to you. Otherwise, you can use calculator. It will give you 1 by root 2. That is root 2. Because he's asking for the exact value, so I am not supposed to use the decimal values. Now see what I have done. I have changed the obtuse angle into, first I have converted cosecant into sine by taking its reciprocal, and then I have changed obtuse angle into acute angle using these rules, and then finally I have taken the value of sine 45. Yesterday I mentioned a table in which I mentioned all these values. Otherwise, you can use calculator. Your calculator also gives these values. So sine 45 will be 1 over root 2. That gives the final answer root 2. Similarly, if I take cot 330 degree. Remember, cot is a reciprocal of tan, so I can write it as 1 over tan 330 degree. Again, I want to change it into acute angle. 330 degree means you are somewhere here. This is 330 degree. Acute angle, I want this much only. The given angle to you is 330. That is from positive x-axis to this line is 330, but I need acute angle. For that purpose, I can write it as tan 360 minus 30. I know it lies in fourth quadrant, and in fourth quadrant tan is negative. So it can be replaced by 1 over negative tan 30 degree. The value of tan 30 is 1 over root 3. So your final answer is negative root 3. So even these formulas are not in your mind, from the grid you can decide what is the value, what is the acute angle, and what is the sine of the trigonometric ratio. So I have 330, I know it lies in the fourth quadrant. If I need an acute angle, I have subtracted 330 from 360. 330 minus 360 is equal to 360 minus 30 is equal to 330. So this expression can be written as simply as negative tan 30, because I am taking this angle. It is in fourth quadrant where tan is negative, and I'm just considering 30 degree. Tan of 30 is 1 over root 3. That gives me minus root 3. Secant 5 pi by 6, and I want its exact value. 5 pi by 6, where does it lies? First of all, you have to judge where does it lies. It lies in second quadrant, somewhere here. So I can write it as secant. If I subtract it from pi, I get this angle. So pi minus 5 pi by 6 give me pi by 6. So it can be written as secant pi minus pi by 6. So if I subtract pi by 6 from pi, it gives me 5 pi by 6. Secant can be changed into sine, into cos. So I can write it as cos pi minus pi by 6. So using this rule, I can write it as 1 over cos pi by 6. And because it lies in second quadrant, that's why cos is negative. So cos pi by 6 cos will be root 3 by 2. This is how we use our grid to change the obtuse angle into acute angle. And then finally, you have to use the value of the acute, cos acute angle. And keep in mind which quadrant the angle lies. If it lies in second quadrant, the cos is negative. That's why I use the negative sign here. Otherwise, for sine is positive, for tan it is also negative. Now the question says solve. Now you don't need to use exact values, you can use a calculator. Like he says, solve secant x is equal to 3, and you know, and your range for x is given 0 to 360, all four quadrants are available. I'm going to change, take the reciprocal, 1 over cos x is equal to 3. If I take reciprocal of both sides, I can say cos x is equal to 1 over 3. So x is equal to cos inverse of 1 over 3. Here I need to use the calculator. Cos inverse 1/3. It is 70.5. It gives me an angle here, 70.5. Remember, calculator will give you the base angle. Base angle means angle from nearest x-axis. So because cos is positive, so cos positive lies in first quadrant and is in third quadrant. So also I need one angle, 70.5. That is 70.5, and other angle will be, we have to measure from the positive x-axis, that will be 360 minus 70.5. So these are the two angles. Solve 2 cot x plus 5. 2 cot x plus 5 is equal to 0. Again, first I have to make cot x a subject. Then I will change, take the reciprocal of cot. That will be 1 over 10. If I take reciprocal of both sides, I'll get 10 x is equal to minus 2 over 5. So x is equal to 10 inverse of minus 2 over 5. Remember, 10 is negative. 10 is negative, so it means it must lie in second quadrant and in fourth quadrant. Your angle, required angle, lies in second quadrant or in fourth quadrant because 10 is negative. To find the value, I'll use the calculator. Shift 10. It gives me 21.8. That is the base angle. Remember this, it gives negative 21.8. So base angle is 21.8. That is from the nearest x-axis. So your required angle is 180. Minus 21.8 and 360 minus 21.8.
you have to calculate these two angle.
Is 158.2, 338.2. Time. Okay. So one more problem for you, and the rest you will do yourself. Now the question says, your range is -180 to 180. It means you can give answer in this range or in this range. You have two options. Positive 180 means you have to move clockwise from 0 to 180, and negative 180 means you have to move anti-clockwise from 0 to 180. So I'm just taking one example as secant square cot 9 cot square cot square 1 by 2x is equal to 4. So I can say cot square 1 by 2x is equal to 4 by 9. If I take the reciprocal of both sides, so the reciprocal of cot is 10 and its reciprocal is 9 by 4. Taking square root, we get 10 1 by 2x is plus minus 3 by 2. One thing keep in mind, over angle is x, but here the angle mentioned is half x. So your range is now half. Now you have for 1 over 2x, your range is 90 to negative 90. So you can only give answer from in this direction and this direction. This is 90 and negative 90. So if we take 10 inverse of positive 3 by 2, we can consider both sign later. Shift 10 is 56.3. So 56.3 is your base angle. And the other one is also negative 56.3. So two answers you have to give because of positive negative sign. So it is equal to positive negative 56.3. Then you have to multiply by 2. So 2 into plus minus 56.3. So this is your final answer after multiplying, simplifying it. Let me check the answer. It's 3A. Okay. That's all for today. I'll send you the worksheet and you must try it at home. Thank you very much.